I've been quoted many times for saying something that is obvious. You can do anything, but not everything. Let me give some story about this. I spent some time around a corporate culture that had a reputation for expecting people to be working by 8 a.m. and staying until 9 p.m. if you wanted to get ahead, or even just stay even in your job. Though people didn't feel self-conscious about taking off an afternoon to go get a medical exam, they would feel uncomfortable being seen leaving work in time to spend quality time with their children, you know, in the evening. It was a culture where anyone who is anyone has much more to do than they can possibly do, and their boss, who's even more swamped, needs a billion things done now. At least, so it appeared. I wonder. Everyone I talked to there felt the same way. No one wanted it to be that way. Did the emperor really have clothes on there? So let me share some random thoughts of mine on this subject. Company cultures should acknowledge when what's required to get the job done is a workforce of 25-year-olds on a decade-long adrenaline rush with not much other life but work. As soon as they turn 35, they can move on to other pastures. I know of job profiles that have been defined that way, and no one involved is upset about it. It's accepted. Another thought. As soon as someone lets themselves stay longer than, you know, agreed upon hours, a code is often broken, which says, I can now hang out and not be particularly focused on efficiency or strategy because I'm going to be here forever anyway. Try firing anyone who's still there after 5 p.m., and I'll bet a lot of working smarter will show up. The assumption that, you know, everyone can and should do everything they have been given to do is an old industrial paradigm that does not hold water for knowledge workers who all have tons of projects that could be done infinitely better. Renegotiating agreements and standards with ourselves and our world is an unfamiliar but required skill for the majority of the workforce for the next century. And, you know, my radical point of view is this. Maybe people just need to do what they feel like doing. When they feel like doing it, let the chips fall as they may and learn and course correct, you know, from their experience. You know, the Puritan ethic, which is, if I'm not feeling guilty about how much harder I should be working than I am, I'm going to hell, could take some course correction itself.